Yes, we are live.
Good evening, friends. I welcome you to today's seminar on issues in ITC. I would now request our tax practitioners, President Bharat Sadev, to kindly take over and welcome all the participants.
So, friends, good evening. Welcome back after a long time. We are happy that today CA Rajat Gurnani is with us, and he is going to take up issues in ITC. But I know he's going to do a good job, so I'm not going to comment about how the, what work he's going to do. But what I'm happy to know that we have restarted. The lockdown has against helped us again to come together on the e-platform. So let us look forward to more seminars, and in this new set of series which we have started today, series 2. So this is the first seminar in the series, and Atam, President of Taxpan, Atam Bhai is also here, and I and Atam Bhai would do more such seminars with the help of Vijay Bhai, and I will be looking forward to the Rajat can again join us in the future with other topics. So yes, Rajat, over to you, and you can start.
Yeah, sure. So before we start, I would request Tanya to please initiate the session, and then we can start here.
Tanya, over to you.
Yeah. So a very warm welcome to all the participants who are joining today's session. I hope you all are doing fine and are safe during this lockdown. It's been a tough time for all of us. So please stay safe, because when you will be safe and healthy, then only we could move for our learning. So if I introduce for today's faculty, Rajat Gurnani is a chartered accountant by profession. His core competency and area of expertise is indirect taxation, specializing in all aspects of GST. He is an eminent speaker who has been appointed many recognitions. He has addressed 100 plus webinars and seminars on GST in various associations across India, and had always been admired by tax professionals for his interactive presentations. He carries a blend of industrial and professional knowledge with vast experience in financial technology sector, and has worked previously with Ramco Systems in India, Australia, Malaysia, and currently he is associated with Open Financial Technologies, ventured headquartered based out of Bangalore. Over to you, Rajat.
Yeah, thank you so much for the wonderful introduction, Tanya. Also, before we start the session, I especially thank all the participants who have joined today's session. And thank you so much to all the
Rajat ji, please start.
Yes, yes. So I especially thank to all the committee members, Tax Friends Mumbai, Tax Practitioner Association Thane, Income Tax Bar Association Prayagraj, UAT Tax Practitioner Association, Josh Professional Foundation Thane. See, there are so many associations who have united together and formed conducted a single webinar on a single platform. That's actually an achievement. Association of Tax Practitioners Bangalore, Legal Relief Society Kolkata, Income Tax Bar Association Vadodara, and a special thanks to Vijay ji, who is my very good friend since long time. And we were actually planning for a webinar, but unfortunately I was not well. I was on bed almost for a month or two. The situation is very tough, but still I have now recovered, and I am trying my level best to speak, to share knowledge as much as possible with you, all you people. And we can now start the session. Only 3-4 important points before we start. This will be a super interactive and super engaging session. So please don't think that, okay, the screen is in front of us and we'll sleep and listen. No, you cannot. You have to keep on answering in the chat box. There's a chat box on your screen. And please make sure you listen to every point, whatever I explain, because I'll be asking questions to you. It will be a super engaging session. Second, what I'll be teaching you today, what I'll be sharing with you today, might be something which you would be already knowing. However, there will be many new things which you won't be knowing, right? So please be attentive, and I'll be explaining the notification circulars orders in a totally different manner, right? So because see, books to everybody, sabke paas books hai. Everybody can study from the books at their home or office, right? What is the benefit of attending the webinar? So the best part is you will, at the end of the webinar, you will feel that actually you have the value, the worth of attending, giving your precious 1.5 hours, right? Next is PPT, the presentation which I will be presenting today. I will be sharing that presentation exclusively for you all at the end of the session. a link will be generated on the screen, and then you can download the presentation from there itself, right? If still you are not able to download, no problem, we will email you also the presentation after the session. Another is, the internet is all good from our side, the network is all good from my side. If you are not able to attend the session, please check your internet connection or just press the reconnect button which is on your screen, and the session will be active back again. Questions you can ask in the chat box. We will discuss the questions at the end of the session. So whatever questions you have, you can keep for the Q&A session at the end. And last but not the least, there is so much of negativity going on around us. Let's for the next 1.5 hours or 2 hours stay positive and learn as much as possible and divert our mind towards the compliance, GST compliance work, which is actually our bread and butter. That is very much important. Now let's start the session. Let me share my screen and let me know when it is visible. So yeah, I have opened my presentation and I am sharing the screen now. So I hope now my screen is visible. So the agenda for today is issues in ITC, and not only the issues, we will also be discussing what is actually going on with the provisions right now, what are the notifications which are coming up, and many other things as well, right? So let me go into the screen. So before understanding the issues, it is very important. Just give me a minute. Let me check whether everything is okay from my side. Yeah, this is okay. Yes, it's all good from my side now. Let me share the screen again. Yes, so I can see that already 180 plus members have joined us even in this tough time. So I really appreciate all of you. I can see in the chat box many people are writing glad to have you sir, glad to see you sir back here. So yeah. So before we start discussing the issues in ITC, it is very important to understand the consequences as well. Because until unless we won't be knowing what are the consequences if we avail the ITC wrongly or utilize the ITC wrongly, then it would be very difficult to understand the provisions as well. Right? So it is very important to understand. So now the consequences, if I tell you right now, So if I tell you the consequences, since the agenda is input tax credit, it is very important to understand what is input tax credit, right? Because what happens is we generally jump to the conclusion and we don't understand what is the meaning of all the terms as per section 2 of the CGST. So it is very important to understand that. I would request all the presenters to please go on mute because there's a slight disturbance in between. Yeah, thank you so much. So input tax, still I can see a bit disturbance. I would request all the presenters to please go on mute. Yeah, thank you. So input tax credit means the credit of input tax. Sir, ye kya samjha rahe ho? Humne ye sab padha hua hai, right? What are you trying to explain? You know that, okay, input tax credit means the credit of input tax. But there are many a times we ask that iska ITC milega, iska input tax milega. At least we should know from the definition what is input tax means. Now as per section 2 subsection 63, input tax credit means the credit of input tax. Now what does input tax means? So as per section 2 subsection 62, input tax in relation to a registered person means the CGST, SGST, IGST or UTGST charge on any supply of goods or services. Also includes the IGST charge on import of goods. So, kiska ITC milega sir? CGST will get, SGST, IGST, UTGST, IGST on import of goods, right? Also, the RCM ITC, right? This is very important. 9 subsection 3, 9 subsection 4. So, these 5 provisions are also included in the input tax definition. Last but not the least, they have mentioned, but does not include the tax paid under the composition levy. This is a very important. Many professionals ask me, sir, composition of ITC kyu nahi le sakte, kaha pe likha hai, where it is written. So we can clearly say that sir, section 2 subsection 62 is clearly written that input tax does not include the tax paid under the composition levy. Okay, Ashwin Thakkar ji is also there with us, Loharuka ji is there with us, people from Maharashtra, people from Uttar Pradesh, all over the country, people have joined us. I can see on my screen. Thank you so much for joining. And yes, we will continue the session. Yes. So now moving ahead. Now what are the consequences as I was discussing? See, understanding the consequences is very important. Because what happens is, log kehte hain, are ITC galat avail kar liya to kya hoga? क्या कर लेगी, नोटिस ही तो आएगा साथ में, व्हाट विल हैपन, नोटिस विल कम, ही विल रिप्लाई. सर नोटिस तो बहुत पुराना जमाना हो गया. नाउ आई टेल यू सम ऑफ द प्रोविजंस ऑफ द एक्ट, यू विल बी रियली एस्टोनिश्ड टू हियर व्हाट काइंड ऑफ स्ट्रिंजेंट प्रोविजंस आर देयर इन द एक्ट नाउ. Right? It is very important to understand, especially for all the CAs, all the tax professionals in the country, these provisions are very important. Please listen to it here. Section 132, punishment for certain offences. Sir, imprisonment hai, non-available imprisonment hai ITC hai. Can you imagine? Just by availing wrong ITC or utilizing wrong ITC. Non-available imprisonment. To whom? Now the biggest question is to whom? Let's say, for example, I have my client XYZ Private Limited. He has wrongly availed some ITC. Sir, jail to usi ka hogi na, right? We must be thinking, who will be imprisoned, right? It will be the client, right? No. Now clearly see what has the amendment come. Notification number 92, Central Tax, dated 22nd December 2020. The notification came and the amendment came in this. It says, earlier the provisions were, whoever commits any of the following offences, that's it. Whoever commits, right? So commit kaun karta hai sir? Business, right? So your client will be committing. You must be thinking the client will go to the jail. No. Now see the amendment. Whoever commits or causes to commit and retain the benefits arising out of, please understand the law language very carefully. Whoever commits means the business or causes to commit and retains the benefit. Sir, is it referring to the CAs or the tax professionals? Maybe yes. They haven't said it directly, but please read the law carefully. Any of the following offences, namely, supplies any goods or services with the intention to evade tax, right? Issues any invoices leading to wrongful availment or utilization of input tax credit. Agar, if you claim the wrong, if you claim avail or utilize wrong input tax credit, then also the imprisonment is there. Non-available imprisonment. To whom? Not only to the business, but also to a person who causes to commit and retain the benefit. Benefit may be the professional fee, right? Try to understand. Point number C. Avails, there is also an amendment in this C number. Avails input tax credit using the invoice or bill referred to in clause B or fraudulently avails ITC without any invoice or bill. Because there was so many frauds happening for ITC, reason why these amendments are come, right? Point number D, clause number D, collects any amount as tax but fails to pay the same to the government. If these four things happens, then whoever commits or causes to commit shall be punishable. In case where the amount of tax evaded is more than 5 crore rupees, with imprisonment for a term which may extend to 5 years and it's fine. Sir, agar if that amount of tax evaded is more than 5 crore rupees, the imprisonment term is 5 years plus fine. Imagine, these kind of stringent provisions have come for ITC. Reason why I always say, the issues in ITC are increasing very much these days, right? So this is very important to understand. Next, in cases where the amount of tax evaded exceeds 2 crore rupees, then the imprisonment will be for 3 years with fine, right? And the offense if increases, the amount of tax evaded is more than the is more than 1 crore rupees, then the imprisonment also is for 1 year plus 5. So this section 132 is very important to understand. Recently an amendment came on 22nd December 2020 which has brought in these provisions, right? Next, now cognizable and non-believable. Please note down, cognizable and non-believable imprisonment. Next, what is the consequence? The second consequence. Section 122. Sir, ye sab kya padha rahe hume kuch samajh nahi aa raha. We only know section 16 subsection 2. Section 16, subsection 4. I'll be discussing those as well, along with the judgments which are come recently. However, it is very important to understand if we don't comply to those provisions, what will happen, right? Because when the client comes to your office, sir, agar main ye karunga to kya hoga, bas wo bata dijiye, right? At least you should be aware of the consequences first. Section 122, penalty for certain offences. Also in the chat box, please, I would love to see your comments whether you are able to understand the provisions or not. How are you feeling, whether the presentation is interactive, you are able to understand, or if you want me to repeat some provisions, please let me anytime. Section 122, penalty for certain offences. Now 132 was for imprisonment, 122 is for penalty, only penalty. 132 imprisonment, 122 penalty. Notification number 92, the same day, 22nd December 2020, it says any person Now see the language. How do they draft the law? It is very important to understand. We all are professionals. Any person who retains the benefit of a transaction, and at whose instance such transaction is conducted. Take a word of meaning, sir. Every word has a meaning. Are they referring to tax professional? Are they referring to CS? Maybe yes. If you see the language, indirectly maybe yes, right? Because we take the professional fee from the client, and at our instance only he does the activity, whatever we ask him. Shall be liable to the penalty of an amount equivalent to the tax evaded or ITC availed of or was passed on, right? Now, what are the relevant clauses? So, if the case is out of these four clauses, then the penalty will be levied. Now, what are the four clauses? What are the relevant four clauses? Supplies any goods, almost similar to Section 132. Supplies any goods or services without any issue of invoice, or issues an invoice or issues an incorrect or false invoice with regards to such supply. Issues any invoice or bill without supply of goods or services, or both in violation of the provisions of this Act. Takes or utilizes input tax credit, clause number 7. Takes or utilizes ITC without actual receipt of goods. Clause number 9. Takes or distributes ITC in contravention of Section 20 of the Rules Made Thereunder. So, out of these four clauses, if anything happens, there will be a penalty levied not only to the client but also to the person who retains the benefit of the transaction and at whose instance such transaction is conducted. Okay? Next, third consequence. Section 29 read with Rule 21. Section 29 read with Rule 21. I can see in the comment that chat box that many people are saying we are able to understand. Please let us know whether all are able to understand or not. We need to make this presentation super interactive and engaging for all of you, right? So please mark yes, yes if you are able to understand. Section 29 read with Rule 21, cancellation of registration. Sir, ITC if you avail wrongly, if you utilize wrongly, the whole Act comes to the picture. All the sections, 132, 122, Section 29. Now, what does the cancellation of registration say? Also, we are receiving many notices with respect to this. So, we should be knowing why are we receiving the notices. Rule 21 of CGST Rules 2017, what does it state? It states, the registration granted to a person is liable to be cancelled if the said person, these were the four earlier clauses, A, B, C, D. There is no amendment to these four clauses. These four clauses were earlier also there. Right. Now, what is the amendment which has come? The amendment which came is in the said rules, Rule 21, in clause B, out of those four clauses, after the word goods or services, the words or both shall be inserted. After clause D, now there were four clauses, right? There were four clauses for cancellation of registration. The fifth clause has been added, the sixth clause has been added, the seventh clause has been added. Clause number E. This has been added recently, please note down. Avails ITC in violation of provision of Section 16 of the Act. Many of the professionals used to tell me, sir, Section 16 comply nahi kiya, kya ho gaya? ITC to reverse karwayenge, dekha jayega, notice aayega, we'll look at you. Sir, your registration will be cancelled if you avail ITC against the violation of the provision of Section 16. Another clause, furnishes the details of outward supplies in GSTR 1. For one or more tax period, which is in excess of the outward supplies declared by him in his valid return under Section 29. You understood? 3B mein aapne 100 rupaye ki sale dikhai. GSTR 1 mein aapne 120 rupaye ki sale dikhai. To bhi aapka registration cancel ho sakta hai. I will repeat. Furnishes the details of outward supplies in GSTR 1, which is in excess. GSTR was in excess of 3B. 39 section is GSTR 3B, right? Another clause, violates the provision of Rule 86B. Now, what is this Rule 86B? Let's try to understand. Animesh Mittalji is also there with us. I really appreciate it, sir. Thanks for joining today. Almost, I can see 200 plus people have joined with us today. Even in this tough time, you people are there to learn. Thank you so much. Violates the provision of Rule 86B. Now, what is Rule 86B? We'll discuss. The crux is, three clauses has been added for cancellation of registration. Right? Please note. Next consequence. Section 29, read with Rule 21A. Read with Rule 21A, this is in addition to cancellation. So, first stage is cancellation. Second is suspension. Now, what is this suspension? Kya hoga sir if we will wrongly claim ITC? Right? Very important to understand. Where a registered person has applied for cancellation of this? One is so important. कि आपने खुद अप्लाई किया था कैंसिलेशन ऑफ रजिस्ट्रेशन के लिए, देन दी ज्यूरिडिक्शनल ए और व्हाटएवर ज्यूरिडिक्शनल कमिश्नर जेसी और एसी को पूछ लेकर दी अथॉरिटीज विल बी डूइंग दी सस्पेंशन ऑफ रजिस्ट्रेशन. दिस इज दी मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट, प्लीज नोट डाउन रूल 21A सब रूल 2, वेयर द प्रॉपर ऑफिसर हैज रीजंस टू बिलीव दैट द रजिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ अ पर्सन इज लायबल टू बी कैंसिल्ड. अब ये रीजंस टू बिलीव क्या है सर, बता सकते हैं? The reasons to believe are nowhere listed. However, since these there were already 7 clauses which were added in the previous rule, which I already showcased. So, as per my opinion, these will be the 7 clauses. So, where the proper officer has reasons to believe that the registration of a person is liable to be cancelled under Section 29 or under Rule 21, which we just now discussed, he may, after affording the said person a reasonable opportunity of being heard, suspend the registration of such person. So, what was written in this? It was written, a reasonable opportunity of being heard will be given and then the registration will be suspended, right? Now, there is a catch. Now, there is a suspense. Now, there is an issue in this. What is the issue? I would request not to move the picture because the concentration for the audience also goes off. Please request. Please let the picture stay there wherever it is. Yeah. Now, the next clause. The amendment which came. The amendment which came is very dangerous, I tell you now. So, what was the amendment in this, right? The amendment which came recently is, after affording the said person a reasonable opportunity of being heard, shall be omitted. Can you imagine? Constitution of India states that it is a right, right? And they are taking the right. Sarjan Sonarji, please again repeat. No problem, sir. Main repeat karta hu. So, suspension of registration kar sakte hain agar reasons to believe hain aur reasonable opportunity di jayegi assessee ko. But, ab jo amendment type, the amendment which came is very dangerous. The amendment is, jo reasonable opportunity deni thi, wo hi hata di gayi. They have removed the reasonable opportunity. They are saying that the suspension of registration will be done without even giving the reasonable opportunity. This is very dangerous. This is the biggest issue in ITC at this point of time, if you ask, right? So this was the amendment which came in Rule 21A. Other amendment also came, which is not related to ITC, rather GSTR one, which I won't be discussing. I have already kept in the presentation. You can look at the presentation afterwards. Whatever will be related to ITC, anywhere in the law, I will explain to you. So this is all the other amendments which came for Rule 21A. Now coming to Input Tax Credit Restriction Rule 86B, which we discussed. The registration will be cancelled as per Section 22, Rule 21, Section 29, Rule 21, if the assessee violates the provision of Rule 86B, right? Now what is Rule 86B? Let's try to understand. In the said rules after Rule 86A, the following rule shall be inserted. Restrictions on use of amount. They are putting a restriction on using of electronic credit ledger, notwithstanding anything contained in these rules, right? Object, notwithstanding clauses are starting with. The registered person shall not use the amount available. Again, Constitution of India. It is hurting me a lot. It is taking my right away. I have the money in my credit ledger, but I cannot use, right? Discharge in liability towards output tax in excess of 99% of such tax liability in cases where the value of taxable supply other than the exempt supply and zero rated supply in a month exceeds 50 lakh rupees. So what are they trying to say? Let me conclude it for you. They are saying if your value of taxable supply other than exempt supply and zero rated supplies in a month exceeds 50 lakh rupees, then you cannot utilize, you cannot pay the 100% output tax by setting off the ITC ledger, input tax credit ledger. You cannot. You can only utilize 99% of it. However, 1% you have to pay by cash. Very stringent rule, right? Rule 86B. They have given certain exceptions also, provided that the said restriction shall not apply there. There are 4 exceptions to it. I'll crack it for you. I'll summarize it for you. What are the restrictions which they have given? They are saying, if you have paid more than 1 lakh rupees in income tax in each of the last 2 financial years, agar aapne pichle 2 saal mein 1 lakh rupees se zyada ka income tax diya hai, then this rule is not applicable for you, right? Second is the registered person has received the refund amount of more than 1 lakh rupees in the preceding financial year. If you have received the amount refund amount of more than 1 lakh rupees, then this rule 86B is not applicable for you. If you have received the refund under section under clause 2 of section 54 of subsection 3, there are actually two clauses in section 54 refund. So both the clauses, if you have refund, received the refund of more than 1 lakh rupees, then this rule is not applicable for you. And another exception is if you have discharged the liability towards output tax through electronic cash ledger. If you have already discharged the output tax liability through electronic cash ledger for an amount which is in excess of 1% of the total output tax liability applied cumulatively. अगर क्यूमुलेटिवली मैं हिंदी में समझा देता हूँ, अगर आपने एक साथ मिला के क्यूमुलेटिवली मिला के पूरे फाइनेंशियल ईयर में अब तक, लेट्स से टुडे इज 24th, अभी तो फाइनेंशियल स्टार्ट हुआ, सो अब तक अगर आपने टोटल मिला के क्यूमुलेटिवली अप्रैल मंथ का 1% से ज्यादा आपने कैश में दे दिया है, देन दिस रूल इज नॉट एप्लीकेबल, राइट? सो दिस रूल इज वेरी स्ट्रिंजेंट एंड इट शुड बी, यू नो, इट शुड बी चैलेंज्ड बिफोर द कोर्ट ऑफ लॉ. And we should actually, we should actually raise our voice against this rule, because this rule violates my even Constitution of India, article in the Constitution. Again, the exception, these exceptions were obvious. If the registered person is a government department, PSU, local authority or a statutory body, this rule 86B is not applicable, right? Blocking of ledger, the last biggest consequence. If you are doing something wrong in ITC, your credit ledger will be blocked. Rule 86 say. My audience is saying, sir, ye kaise rules bata rahe aap ITC mein? We haven't heard these kind of rules or sections. We have heard only section 16. Section 16, subsection 2, section 16, subsection 4. We haven't heard these kind of rules, right? Rule 86 say, blocking of ledger. Again, what was Rule 86A? It came long back in 2019. Long back in 2019, notification number 75. However, the notices have been issued recently. Reason why I have kept Rule 86A also in the presentation. So, what does Rule 86A say? It says if the commissioner has reasons to believe, if the commissioner has reasons to believe that the credit of input tax has been availed on the strength of tax invoices prescribed under Rule 36, non-existent. जिस टैक्स इनवॉइसेस के बेस पे मैंने आईटीसी क्लेम किया वो टैक्स इनवॉइस ही एग्जिस्ट नहीं करते, राइट? या फिर उस प्लेस ऑफ बिजनेस से बिजनेस कंडक्ट हो रहा है जहां पे वो बिजनेस ही नहीं एग्जिस्ट करता है, दिस इज द फर्स्ट रीजन. और विदाउट द रिसिप्ट ऑफ गुड्स और सर्विसेज और गुड द क्रेडिट ऑफ, ओके, यू आर नॉट एबल टू बी, नो प्रॉब्लम, वी कैन टेक द कैमरा ऑन द टॉप, आई होप इट्स क्रेडिबल नाउ. The credit of input tax has been availed on the strength of tax invoices, the tax charge in respect which have not been paid to the government. Rule 86A, right? They are actually blocking our credit ledger because of this reason. These are the reasons, right? It came long back in 26 December 2019, almost 1.5 years back. Another reason, the registered person availing the credit of input tax, this is very important. Why the notices are coming, I'll tell you. People were availing ITC on fraudulently basis. They were issuing tax invoices whereas the place of business itself was not existing. So they are saying the registered person availing the credit of input tax has been found non-existent. Jisne avail kiya, wahi exist nahi karta, right? Or not to be conducting any business from any place for registration has been obtained. So now if these are the three reasons, if rather these are the four reasons, not in the possession of tax invoice, then what will happen? May, for reasons to be recorded in writing, not allow debit of an amount, not allow debit of an amount equivalent to such credit in electronic credit ledger for discharge of any liability under section 49 or for claim of any refund of any unutilized amount. So they are blocking our credit ledger, right? They are blocking our right to use the credit ledger. The commissioner, if he is satisfied that it does not, the fraudulent fraud does not longer exist, then he may allow such payment. Such restrictions shall cease to have effect after the expiry of period of 1 year. So they are actually imposing the restriction for a period of 1 year. Rule 86K is getting. Now, what are the issues which I am facing in Rule 86? Let me tell you one by one. Article 300A of Constitution of India. No person shall be deprived of his property save by authority of law. many of the professionals ask me, sir, GST audit is भी बंद हो गया, tax audit की limit भी बढ़ गई, करें तो सर क्या करें? Sir, litigation is a very important field of practice. I'm telling you, if you are able to see the issues right now in ITC, you would have till now got the opportunity कि यार इसमें we can practice, right? Litigation is a very important topic, especially in GST 5.0. All these provisions will go into litigation. I'm telling you, all these provisions. No person shall be deprived of his property saved by the penalty of law. Another issue, it is violation of principle of natural justice. Violation of principle of natural justice, sir. No show cause notice, no opportunity of being heard. Very good. Such stringent provisions, right? Rules are overriding the provisions of law. First time ever I have seen, right? Rules are overriding the provisions of law. There is no section, rule has come up. Rule 36 sub-rule 4 is the practical biggest example. So these were the consequences which will happen if you will not properly claim ITC, if you will not properly reconcile ITC, if you will not properly avail or utilize the ITC. Right? Now we will start what are the issues in claiming or in reversal or in refund of ITC, or let's discuss now. Right? One by one we will start. First is claim. Now, when can I claim input tax credit? Right? When can I claim input tax credit? So can somebody tell me in the chat box how many conditions I have to fulfill if I want to claim ITC? How many conditions are there if I want to claim ITC? How many conditions I need to check? Please, I would request all my participants to please comment in the chat box, because it is very important to stay awake, stay engaged, and then learn. Please, I would request everybody to please comment in the chat box. I can see the comments coming up. So there are 4 conditions. Somebody is saying there are 3 conditions. Please tell me, section 16, subsection 2. How many conditions do we need to check? I would love to see all the interactive audience, all the engaging audience. Please, please let us know. Ravindra Singh is saying, great session with good learning. Rohit is saying, 5 conditions. Okay, great, great. Please mention in the chat box, how many conditions we need to check? Prateek is saying, 4 conditions. Great, okay. Please keep on mentioning in the chat box. Almost 200 plus people are there with us. Chanal Jain ji saying 5 conditions, okay? 5 conditions, Rohan ji. Arvind ji, 4. Having valid tax return. Praveen ji has already mentioned 1 condition. Okay, great, great. Okay. Now let's understand what are the conditions. So notwithstanding anything contained in this section, no registration person, no registered person shall be entitled to claim the input tax credit in respect of any supply of goods or services or both to him. Chetan Yadav ji, 4. Neha ji, 4. Venkatesan ji from Vellore, 4. Thank you so much, sir. Rishi ji, 4. Thank you, thank you. Yeah. So now let's start. Possession of tax invoice, right? Sanjeev Mishra ji is also there with us. Murli Krishna ji, great to see, sir. Great to see. All my friends have joined. Pankaj Ahuja ji, great, sir. Great. Lakshman ji, 3 conditions. Sir, 3 to nahi hai. At least 4. Possession of a tax invoice. Received the goods, right? What is the 3rd condition? The tax has been paid in respect of such supply. What is the 4th condition? He has furnished the return in the section. Sir, these 4 conditions should be on our tips. Should be on our tips, right? While claiming ITC. Possession of tax invoice, received the goods, tax charge in respect of such supply has been paid, furnished the return in the section. Now another question. Another question. Please be ready. Pankaj Ahuja ji, please be ready. My question to you is, for tax invoice, I have the tax invoice, I have received the goods, right? I have the tax invoice, I have received the goods. I have furnished the return also, 3B, GST or 3B also I have furnished. So return under section 13, everything I have done, right? But I don't know whether my supplier has paid the taxes or not. Because I cannot check, it is practically not possible to check whether my supplier has paid taxes or not, right? How will I check? I will give you a practical example. What happens, for example, invoice number 320, invoice number case study, invoice number 320, right? He raised invoice number 320, I booked in my purchase account, everything done. According to me, I have the tax invoice, I have received the goods, I can claim the ITC, but I do not know whether he has paid the taxes or not, right? Now what will happen, what I can do on my behalf, right? Sir, 282B mein check, aray sir, 282B abhi chodi hai. 282B to chhod diye sir. Abhi to section ki baat karenge. We all are professionals, right? What is 282B 2C? I don't know, right? Let's understand the section first. Abhi tak to maine 282B bola hi nahi sir. I cannot check, right, whether the tax has been paid or not. So what I do, I take the copies of GSTR DP from my supplier. Maximum I can do that, right? Maximum what I can do, I can take the copy of GSTR 3B from the supplier. I can take the copy of Chalan also, right? But do I know whether he has actually paid the taxes for that specific invoice, invoice number 320? Will I get to know? The answer is no. For example, invoice number 320, the tax amount was, let's say, CGST 50 rupees, SGST 50 rupees, right? Total was 100 rupees. The Chalan amount which I have taken is 20,000 rupees, right? How will I get to know that out of those 20,000, those 50 rupees and 50 rupees exist? Whether he has actually considered that invoice number 320 in that Chalan or GSTR 3B, I cannot. It is impractical. It is practically not possible. The third condition, I can challenge in the court of law. It is practically not possible. Now I'll showcase you a beautiful judgment which has come up. If tax charge in respect of such supply has not been actually paid, I repeat, if tax charge in respect of such supply, the third condition, has not been actually paid, can we claim ITC? Can we claim ITC? There were two judgments which earlier came, Arise India Limited, we all know, Arise India, KK Industries were the two very good judgments which came in favor of the SSE, which says that even if the supplier has not paid the taxes, we can claim the ITC. Arise India Limited, KK Industries. Many of the tax professionals would have surely quoted these judgments in the reply to the notices. Now, beautiful judgment has come recently. Please note down, recently a judgment has come, 24th Feb 2021, sir, this year itself, Bethel Enterprises versus State Tax Officer, Madras High Court. Madras High Court judgment, very nice. Let me read few of the lines which the court of law is saying, right? Which the judge is saying. If the tax, so what happened is, I'll tell you the background. The respondent means the government authorities, they issued a notice to the seller. Saying that when you bought the material, the tax for that material was not paid by the supplier and you claimed the ITC. So now you reverse the ITC and blah blah blah. They have issued the invoice to the seller saying that okay, you are in guilty, right? Now let's read what the court of law is saying. Beautiful judgment. If the tax, what is the court of law saying? Please concentrate. If the tax had not reached the kitty of the government, then the liability may have to be eventually borne by one party, either the seller or the buyer. In the case on hand, the respondent means the government authorities. The respondent does not appear to have taken any recovery action against the seller. Seller name is Charles and his wife Shanti. So these are the sellers on the present transactions, right? Ki unpe to kuch proceedings kari nahi aapne. Ab kya kehte hai? The learned counsel for the petitioner means Bethel Enterprises. The learned counsel for the petitioners draws my attention to the order dated 27th October 2020, finalizing the assessment of the seller by excluding the subject transactions alone. See, I am unable to appreciate the approach of the authorities. Please, this is a very important judgment which you can quote in your replies. I am unable to appreciate the approach of the authorities when it has come out that the seller has collected tax from the purchasing dealer. The omission on the part of the seller to remit the tax in question must have been viewed very seriously, and strict action ought to have been initiated against him. So respondents jo the, jo government authorities thi, wo soch rahi thi, yaar hum ladne to aaye the seller ke liye, ulta hume hi sunne ko mil gaya ki aapne buyer ko kyun reach out kiya, right? Now see the language, that apart in the inquiry question, the Charles and his wife, the buyers, ought to have been examined. Also, let me move the camera on the top. They should have been confronted. This is all the more necessary because the respondent has taken a stand that the petitioners have not even received the goods and had availed input tax credit on the strength of the generated invoice. Now, last 2-3 lines of the judgment. You can download the judgment from the website. I do not have the copy at this point of time, but I have presented the main conclusion. According to the respondent, there was no movement of the goods. Hence, examination of Charles and his wife, the buyer, has become all the more necessary and imperative. When the petitioners have insisted on this, I do not understand as to why the respondent did not ensure the presence of Charles and his wife Shanti in the inquiry. Are you seeing? So actually, if you go with proper, you know, proper deliberation, proper reasons to believe that yes, you are on the correct path, the code of law will surely be there. Thus, the impunitive order suffers from certain fundamental flaws. It has to be quashed for more reasons than one. Imagine, they have totally quashed, right? Non-examination of charges in the inquiry, non-initiation of recovery action against charges in the first place. Therefore, the impunct orders are quashed and the matters are remitted back to the file of the respondent. Imagine, this was the recent Madras High Court judgment. I thought I will share with you, very important judgment. The third reference which you can give after Arise India and KK Industries. Please move. I hope you like this judgment. Now let's move forward. So what happened? Section 16, four conditions, right? We just now studied only four conditions. Now what happened is, the government realized, finally the government realized, ki yaar, only four conditions, somewhere we are going wrong. They introduced a new clause in the Finance Bill 2021. They introduced a new clause. What was the new clause? Recently only in the budget. Clause 100 of Finance Bill 2021. What does this clause say? In Section 16 of the CGST Act in Subsection 2, just now we studied 16 Subsection 2, after Clause A, there were four clauses, right? After Clause A, the following clause shall be inserted, namely, double A clause, the details of the invoice or debit note referred to in Clause A has been furnished by the supplier in the statement of output supplies. Sir, thoda Hindi mein bhi samjha do kya kehna chahte hain. Kehna ye chahte hain कि एक क्लॉज 100 ऑफ फाइनेंस बिल 2021 ऐड हुआ है इस पर जो कहता है कि अगर आपके सप्लायर ने वो वाला इनवॉइस GSTR1 में नहीं डाला तो आप आईटीसी क्लेम नहीं कर सकते हैं बट देयर इज अ सब्जेक्ट टू दिस दिस क्लॉज इज स्टिल नॉट नोटिफाइड इन द एक्ट सो प्लीज बी पेशेंट एंड वेट फॉर इट टू बी नोटिफाइड दिस क्लॉज इज स्टिल नॉट नोटिफाइड आई एम अगेन रिपीटिंग So right now, if you ask me, there are only four clauses which you need to look at, which I have already explained, 16 subsection 2. These are the only four clauses at this point of time. However, one clause is about to be added in the Act, and then there will be five clauses. Rather, one sub-clause and four main clauses. Now, sir, tell me, many of the participants always ask me in the webinars, we have already done 100 plus seminars, webinars, clause. So people ask me, sir, ye bata dijiye. Just tell us कि 2A 2B तो है ही नहीं यहाँ पे ये हम जो 2A 2B खेल रहे हैं या rule 36 सब rule 4 खेल रहे हैं 5% 10% 15% 20% ये तो है ही नहीं यहाँ पे आपने जो पढ़ा there were only four clauses fifth is about to come then what is 2A 2B from there 2A 2B came now we will study and we will analyze also whether 2A or 2B or rule 36 4 is imposing any condition is mandatory, is binding on the law or not. Or it is only directory in nature. Very important, please. Now, before moving forward, I have made one small analysis on this clause 100, which I want to discuss with you. Food for thought, over to you. What analysis I made is, for example, if now they have realized that from a date, prospective basis, this will not be retrospective basis. From prospective basis, from XYZ date, they will notify this clause, right? The date from which they will notify, this clause will be applicable only from that date. Agreed? Right? So, till now, whatever ITC I have claimed, I had to check only those four conditions. Agreed? Right? So, there is no 2A 2B till now. Right? This is the only section, section 16, subsection 2. There is no 2A 2B till now. Till the date this clause will be notified. Afterwards, what will happen? Once the clause is notified, we will get to know. But till now, since there is nothing in the law, that means whatever ITC I was claiming, fulfilling those four conditions, is okay. Right? It's good. So whatever notice comes in, please make sure you, reply to along with all these points. Many professionals ask me, sir, how to reply to this ITC notice. I say, ek bar webinar pe aao, copy pen leke baitho. नोट डाउन करो एनालिसिस करो आपको रिप्लाई खुद मिल जाएगा ठीक है नाउ लेट्स मूव फॉरवर्ड सो नेक्स्ट इज ओके आई हैव टेकन द क्लॉजेस ऑफ सेक्शन 37 व्हिच यू कैन रीड इट आफ्टरवर्ड्स दिस इज ऑल द लॉ रूल 59 रूल 60 Now the biggest question of the era at this point of time, sir, ये two way क्या है? सर इतना तो पता है, Excel है two way, but ये two way क्या है? Please explain us. मजा आया ना सबको? All you are enjoying, right? You all are enjoying. I hope none of you are getting bored. So form GSTR 2A statement is a statement. Notification number 79. Form GSTR 2A is a statement. Somebody is saying, sir, GSTR 2A is mentioned in the law. I am not denying. When I said it is not mentioned in the law, it is mentioned in the law. But the section which says that you need to claim ITC fulfilling these four conditions has no reference to 2A. Please note there is a big difference between being in the law and bounding by the law. Bounded by the law, imposed by the law. Please, there's a big difference, right? Now, form GSTR 2 is a statement which has been generated on the basis of the information furnished. It is a dynamic statement and is updated on a new addition amendment made by SOPI near real time. Law mein aa chuka hai sir, GSTR 2 is now law. Please, bounding hai, wo dekhenge, that we'll see. But GSTR 2 is in law, notification number 79. So, this is a basic detail which they have given as per notification number 79. This information we all know. Now, this is important. This is important. What is GSTR 2A? Sir, 2A to pehle hi tha. Whatever information was being given by 2A, we were already getting that, right? Then why was 2B brought in? Notification number 82, public 2020, central text dated 10th November 2020. Whatever I speak today will be in reference to either a notification, circular, order, or a section. I won't speak anything from my own side. After form 2A, the form 2B shall be inserted. Form 2B is a statement which has been generated on the basis of information furnished by suppliers in GSTR 1. It is a static statement and will be made available once a month. The document filed with the supplier, etc., etc. This is the most important line of my whole session. Please note down. Taxpayers are advised, yes sir, share nahi hai. Law ki language ko samjhe, please understand. Taxpayers are advised to refer form GSTR 2B for availing credit in 3B. However, in case for additional details, they may refer to their respective form GSTR 2A for more details. These two lines, everybody was searching in the law, but exclusively for all of you, I have taken out notification number 82, where it is clearly mentioned taxpayers are advised, not mandatory, to refer form 2B. In case of additional details, they can refer to. Agreed, sir? Answer mil gaya sir sabko? 2A le, 2B le, mil gaya? Ye hai sir. This is the answer. Input tax credit shall be indicated to be non-applicable. Wo ye bata rahe. Now they are telling ki aap band karke 2B ko mat dekhna. Please don't close your eyes and then see 2B. Please refer to section 17, subsection 5 also. Log credit. If your ITC is log, please note down. That will not come into 2B. You have to yourself, you know, get that disallowed ITC from section 17, subsection 5. Please note. So these two points, remember forever. Notification number 82, dated 10th November 2020. Now this is another question which I would like to ask in audience. Please. इतना बुलवा रहे हैं सर, इतना ज्यादा आई एम स्पीकिंग राइट नाउ. यू आल्सो शुड कंटिन्यू प्लीज. आईटीसी इज नॉट अवेलेबल इन 2A और 2B. अब मैंने इतना समझा दिया, आई ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन टू यू, राइट? आईटीसी इज नॉट अवेलेबल इन 2A और 2B. कैन वी क्लेम ऑन सेल्फ असेसमेंट बेसिस? द क्वेश्चन इज कैन वी क्लेम ऑन सेल्फ असेसमेंट बेसिस कंसीडरिंग द न्यू क्लॉज व्हिच हैज कम अप इन द फाइनेंस बिल, कंसीडरिंग द फोर क्लॉजेस इन सेक्शन 16 सबसेक्शन 2. प्लीज टेल मी whether can I claim ITC if it is not available in 2A or 2B. Can I claim on self-assessment basis? Please. If I have fulfilled all the four conditions and I have also fulfilled the upcoming clause booklet. Santosh is saying yes. Sir, how to challenge in the court of law? Sir, be aware of all the updated provisions which are coming up and then you will be able to draft the presentation very nicely. Santosh is saying as per GSTR 1, Venkatesh, yes. Prateek ji, yes, up to 105%. Okay, great. Okay, so mixed answers are coming up. I can see many people are answering and mixed answers are coming up. So even on YouTube channel of Tech Sprint, I can see 150 plus people have joined us and more than, everybody is now posting on YouTube also on the Tech Sprint channel. I can see. Great to see that. Great to see. Uttam Sharma ji is on YouTube channel. Vasudev Chatterjee is on YouTube channel. Bojai Srinivas ji, Rajendra Joshi ji, Divya Gohil ji. Divya Gohil ji unable to hear. Divya ji, please refresh your screen. It is all good from our side. Now let's understand this question. There was a press release which came on 2018, right? What it states? This press release was issued by CBIC. I am telling you, this was issued by CBIC. Nikal ne nazar press release bhi de dunga. It is clarified, but back in 2018, not in 2013. I will tell you what is the position at this point of time also. It is clarified that the furnishing of output details in GSTR1 by the corresponding supplier and the facility to view the same in Blu-ray by the recipient is in the nature of taxpayer facilitation. Facilitation, right? Now, if you connect all the dots, section 16 mein 2 and 2B kahin mentioned nahi hai. Clause 100 mein 2 and 2B kahin mentioned nahi hai. Right? Notification number which I showcased you recently, which states about 2B. It is saying advice to see 2B for claiming credit. Right? Again, they are saying taxpayer facilitation. When you connect all the dots, it is clearly coming up that 2A or 2B is not mandatory. There is no imposition, there is no bounding provision in the law. And does not impact the ability of the taxpayer to avail ITC on self-assessment basis in consonance with the provision of Section 16 of the Act. CBIC ne khud bola tha sir, ki agar aap Section 16 ko fulfill karte ho, aap ITC le sakte ho, GSTR 2A ho, 2B ho, wo aapka right nahi ho sakti hai. Right? ITC is a vested right as per Constitution of India. Another reference, handbook was issued by our respected institute on 21st May 2019. The department may automatically issue notices, letters to the registered person saying that excess credit has been availed or seeking information by valuing this clause is negative. Table A, D, GSTR 9, which automatically populates from GSTR 2. The copy of invoice, the date of payment consideration to the supplier are the primary documents. Sir, ICI said this, our institute, are the primary documents or evidences to be safeguarded by the taxpayer in a case where value in clause D of serial number 8 is negative due to failure on the part of supplier to put information. Right? So please note down all these references. This will help you. Yeah. So this was all about what we were discussing about section 16 subsection 2. There are other things as well, section 16 subsection 4, rule 26 sub rule 4. There are many things still we will be discussing, but before that I want to talk about, just talk 5 minutes about something which is very important at this point of time. See, everybody is now almost working from home. The pandemic time is going on, it is very tough time and we have to run our practice. Unfortunately, the dates have not been extended as of now. I just now read the notification for 148 section assessment. The date has been extended to 30th June, but the due date for the returns have not yet been extended. Maybe I am hopeful that these dates will also extend. However, it is very important to be aware of how to run the practice in this work from home scenario, right? It is very important to start being digital in this scenario. So what I told is, I'll explain about something which is very important for all the CAs, for all the tax professionals who have joined this webinar, and it is exclusively free for tax professionals. It is a very nice tool. Everybody, I would recommend, should use this tool. It will make your work very simple, right? So OptoTex is a knowledge sharing platform along with technology platform. So we share knowledge across the country with all the professionals, and we develop many technology related tools as well to empower the tax professionals, to empower the CA community in the country. And OptoTex is already trusted by 50,000 plus tax professionals across the country for their 1 million plus clients. And we are offering this OptoTex exclusively free. It's been almost now 3 years plus. Everybody is using in the country. I would recommend, if you are still not using, you also should start using. I have already given you the link on your screen that which will help you to get all the details of OptoTex on your email ID. You just need to fill a small form. Just click here to get more details. Just fill a small form. Automatically, an email will come to you and all the details of OptoTex will be there. So, how does OptoTex help tax professionals making GST compliance simple, right? See, we are trying to make tools for financial automation which will help you making your GST compliance work simple in the practice form. The first best example is, whenever we used to prepare All these features have been prepared from feedback. Practical example I'll give you. What used to happen is, whenever I used to prepare a reply for any notice, it used to ask me whether you have filed a 3B or not. So I used to ask my staff member to download all the 12 copies of the acknowledgement and then attach in the, you know, that big consolidation of the papers. So what we did is, we just built one button, one single button to download all the 12 months acknowledgement copies. Just one button. It saved a lot of time for all my article staff members. Increase the efficiency, right? Just one button, download all the acknowledgement for 12 months. Now the best part is, even if you start using CompuText from today, automatically you will be getting data from 1st July 2017. All the past 3 years, 4 years data, you will be getting in CompuText. Once you will log into CompuText, any point of time. This is the beauty of the architecture which we have built in, right? Another best part is that if you are using any other software, no problem at all, sir. You can start using CompuText together with that software. I'm not saying that just, you know, remove that and start using this. No. Even simultaneously, or you can use this. Many of the people are using CompuText for importing and other softwares for return filing, right? So you can use simultaneously as well. Now, another feedback which came is, sir, main to CA hu, main to bas ye dekhna chahta hu, kya mere, whether my all my clients' return has been filed or not. Yes or no, that's it. I just want to have a bird's eye view. Give me a dashboard, right? So what we did is, we built a simple screen saying that, okay, for this client, the return has been filed, this client, the return is pending, right? This is the best way to save your time, to increase your efficiency. Sitting in your chair, you will be able to see all clients, whether 500 clients, 1000 clients, unlimited clients. Return status you can download in Excel as well, right? Challan history. For the full year, you can see what are the challans you have created, even on the portal. Our system is totally integrated with the portal as well. The reports, the beauty of the reports, we have only 10 reports as of date. Only 10. There are many software companies which have seen saying that 100 reports. Sir, utni chahiye, right? Chahiye. The problem is, they make something, they build something, they come to us, we don't understand, we don't have any other option, we just pay them the money and buy. Kaam usse easy nahi hota hai, bas humko satisfaction hai, main software le rakha. Sir, usse nahi hoga. We don't need a software, that kind of software. We need something which actually fulfills our purpose. Only 10 reports, but all yearly. Pure saal ka GSTR 2B, pure saal ka GSTR 2A, right? GSTR 2A in one single Excel for the whole year. For the whole year, GSTR 2A in one single Excel. No monthly, nothing. In just 2 minutes, you can download from this. Party-wise summary, rate-wise summary reports, only 10 reports. GSTR 2A versus purchase reconciliation is very important right now, all automatic. So there are a lot of screenshots which I have kept in my presentation. You can see afterwards. We can move ahead with the knowledge sharing session as well. But just for information, see, technology will be a very big enabler for all our practice firms, right? If we will enable us if we are ready with technology, then our practice firm will flourish like anything. It is very difficult to work in the traditional kind of manner, seeing the upcoming scenario. So these are the screenshots of the software. Arvind ji is saying he is already using from last 1 year. Very easy to use. Thank you so much, sir. User base, delegation authority responsibility, right? We keep on studying, we should delegate our work. The best feature we gave is, somebody said, okay, sir, I have 100 clients. I want to delegate 25 clients each to my 4 articles, to my 4 staff members. We have given the user functionality as well. You can allocate 25 clients each to your 4 articles or 4 star articles, right? So there are a lot of functionalities. QRMP scheme is also there. Now another functionality which we have recently launched is payments. Yes, we are coming with the payments. Even you can pay your GST amount directly from CompuText, from any bank account, from even UPI also. Yes, we are coming up with the functionality. Very soon, you can pay your GST directly from CompuText. So you can file your return, save, submit, file, DSC, EPC, kuch bhi ho sir, CompuText is there for you, right? Arvind ji, password is not getting saved. Arvind ji, we are trying our level best, unfortunately, due to what is happening is, due to some security issues, we do not want to save the password at this point of time, and you can use CompuText just by entering password, you can use it, right? And we are there for you, always give the feedback whenever possible. Yeah, so, I'll just mention the contact details and then let's move forward. If you are not able to fill the form, or support is also there for you, live chat, email, live session on call. YouTube channel, we have Aquatex YouTube channel. There are all the demo videos, how to sign up, how to add clients. You can just search for Aquatex on the YouTube channel. This is our contact number. Please note down the contact number. If you have any queries, then you can ask the support team. And then let's move on. 7252-937-93. Now let's move forward to the law session, right? The issues in ITC session. This is another issue, right? Reconciliation. So Aquatex will help you reconciling ITC in a very effective way. Now coming to Rule 36, Subrule 4. Now what does this rule says? Right? What does this rule says? It says notification number 49/2019. It came on 9th October 2019. Long back. Input tax credit to be availed by registered person with respect of negotiated debit notes which have not been uploaded by the supplier under subsection 1 of section 27 shall not exceed 20%. ये कहते हैं कि अगर supplier के GSTR 1 में कोई invoice upload नहीं हुआ है, तो वो जो amount है, वो 20% of the eligible credit से ज़्यादा नहीं है. It should not exceed 20%. Now what happened? Another amendment came. Notification number 75, 26 December 2019. What does it say? It says, with effect from 1st January 2020, what they have done is reduce the percentage from 20 to 10, right? So in just some time, some period of time, they have reduced the percentage from 20 to 10. Another amendment came, notification number 13, saying that provided that the set condition shall apply cumulatively. This came in the last year, when the pandemic time was going on. They said that, okay, this condition will be applied cumulatively. Cumulatively for 7 months, and you need to comply in the month of September 2020 cumulatively. Another last amendment came, notification number 94, which came recently, which says that for the word uploaded. So instead of the word uploaded, they have now replaced the word furnished. Another amendment is because IFF also came in, right? QRMP also came in, IFF came in. So they said in place of by the suppliers under subsection 1 of section 27, in form GSTR 1 or using the IFF facility shall be inserted. So they have just included the IFF word in the clause. Now reduce the 10% to 5%. 20 say 10 I, 10 say 5 away. Up clause 100 after that. So this 5 will also vanish. This 5 will also vanish. Now the biggest question in Rule 36 Subrule 4 is whether Rule 36 Subrule 4 is legally valid. I would request everybody to please comment on the chat box and tell me whether Rule 36 Subrule 4 is legally valid or not. Please tell me. I can see that cumulatively more than 300 plus tech professionals have joined on all the platforms. I really appreciate the way all they are participating. Sanjay Kulkarni ji, very user friendly of today. Thank you, sir. Harish Chandra Bhatia ji, excellent deliberation. Thank you, Harish ji. It's all your love and support. Mehul ji, good afternoon. Please answer this, sir. Whether Rule 36 Subrule 4 is legally valid, please. I want to see everybody's answer. We all are professionals, sir. We should be very aware of the, very well aware of the, all the provisions of the law. Santosh ji is saying, no, it is not legally valid. Okay. I want to see other answers as well. Whether Rule 36 Subrule 4 is legally valid, sir. Please tell me. Yes, no, yes, no. Venkatesan ji Vellore is saying it is legally valid. Okay. See, this is the confusion. This is the confusion which we have. Practically not possible. I understand, sir. Practically it is not possible, but legally valid hai ki nahi. Right? Wo bhi to dekhna padega, sir. Now I will tell you what happened. So, from where Rule 36 Subrule 4 came? There was no section. Please note down. There is no section for Rule 36 Subrule 4. However, what happened? There is a section 43A, subsection 4 of CGST Amendment Act 2018. Please note down. This is a very important point. There is a section 43A, subsection 4 of CGST Amendment Act 2018, which states that 20% of IGST, my same thing. Whatever Rule 36 Subrule 4 was saying, the same thing section 43A is saying. However, this section is still not effective as on date. This is still not notified. This is still not part of the act, right? still not notified. So the conclusion is whether can a rule is valid other than a section. Means, for example, can a rule stand alone without a section? मतलब सर ये तो वो हो गया कि आपने नींव बनाई नहीं और बिल्डिंग खड़ी कर दी राइट बिना सरियों के बिना पिलर्स के स्टैंडिंग अ बिल्डिंग यू आर ट्राइंग टू स्टैंड दैट बिल्डिंग अप रीजन व्हाई आई एम टेलिंग यू द गवर्नमेंट रियलाइज्ड एंड देन दे हैव ब्रॉट दिस क्लॉज 120 फाइनेंसमेंट 2021 वंस इट इज नोटिफाइड दिस क्लॉज विल नॉट बी वैलिड रादर इट इज स्टिल नॉट वैलिड मे बी दिस क्लॉज दिस रूल 36 सब रूल 4 विल बी टेकन बैक दिस इज फॉर द But still, this rule 36 sub rule 4 is not legally valid. You can challenge in the court of law. There is no section. Yes, there is a section 43A, but it is still not effective as of date. Right? Bharat Patel ji is rightly saying, rule cannot override the IPC claiming provision of section 16 subsection 2. Absolutely, sir. A rule cannot override a section. Yes. Moving ahead. Example of 5% restriction. Total eligible IDC is 10 lakh. Still, some people want to know about Rule 36 sub rule 4. I have given an example. If my eligible IDC is 10 lakh rupees, eligible IDC as per 2A is 6 lakh rupees. So, Rule 36 sub rule 4 says that you can claim IDC of 6.3 lakhs only. 6 lakhs plus 5% of 5% of 6 lakh, which is 20,000. So, 6 lakh plus 20,000, 6 lakh. This is the example which I have quoted. Is it still mandatory to check condition of section 16? Yes, absolutely, sir. Section is the main thing. The circular itself says that it is very important to check the conditions of chapter 5 of CGST Act, that is section 16, right? So this is very important. Don't forget that. Don't forget this. Whether the 5%, somebody asked the question. I just now saw. So whatever questions you have will be already answered in the session. Whether the 5% restriction applies on imports, RCM, IST also. I remember somebody asked in the chat box. No, sir, it does not apply. What the circular says is, it says that the taxpayers may avail full IDC in respect of IGST paid on import documents issued at RCM. Please mute your mic, somebody. I would request thank you. If you can please move the mic, somebody has joined for the presentation just now. Yeah, thank you so much. So the taxpayers may avail full IPC in respect of IGST paid on import documents issued under RCM. Documents issued under RCM, credit received from IGST, right? So this you can claim, there is no 5% restriction on this. Date of applicability, you already know, 9th October 2019, this rule 36 sub rule 4 came. Whether we need to check the 5% restriction supplier-wise, no, it applies cumulatively. Circular number 123 clearly says that the restriction imposed is not supplier-wise, it is from all suppliers cumulatively, right? Whether we need to check the 5% on goal ITC or only the eligible ITC, it is only eligible ITC. You don't need to check the restriction on the goal ITC, only the eligible ITC. Okay? Next is the most important question, which everybody was asking, is sir, 17-18 ka ITC reh gaya hai, 18-19 ka reh gaya hai, 19-20 reh gaya hai, 20-21 bhi aane wala hai. Bata dijiye sir. What is the last date to claim ITC? I have given you for all the four financial years. Please note down with the section. Section 16, subsection 4 states that a registered person shall not be entitled to take IDC after the due date of furnishing of the return under section 39, which was 20th October 2018, or furnishing of the annual return, the date was 5th or 7th Feb 2020. Right? So this was GSTR 9 date. So whichever is earlier is 20th October 2018. However, an order came, please note down, this is for 1718, an order came which states that provided that the registered person shall be entitled to take IPC after the due date of furnishing of the return under section 39, till the due date of furnishing of return under the section for the month of March 2019. So the last date to claim 1780-90C was 23rd April 2019 in legal terms, right? So if any notice comes saying that you have claimed on in March 2019 or February 2019, so please tell them, boss, this is the order number 2, public 2018, dated 31st December. Please kindly refer this order, right? So this order was passed on 31st December 2018. This was for 1790. Now coming to 1890. Lakshmanji, correct. Thank you so much, sir, for agreeing. 1718 we are done. Coming to 1890. Same thing, same section 16th of section 4. So the date for 3B was 20th October 2019 and GCR 9 date was 31st December 2020. Right? These were the two dates, whichever is earlier. So the date to claim, last date to claim ITC for 1890 is actually 20th October 2019. So what happened is, the order which came in 2017-18, unfortunately, that type of order didn't came in 1819, right? So we had to bear with this date. So 20th October 2019 is the only last date to claim ITC for 1819. I hope you have noted this part. Coming to 1920, right? Section 16.4, again the same section. Whatever I will say, reference over, sir. Kuch bhi hawa mein nahi bolunga. Due date for section 39 return GSTR 3B, it was 20th or 22nd or 24th, depending on the states or the turnover. So 24th October 2020, depending on the turnover and state of GST registration, or annual return 31st March 2021, whichever is earlier, right? So the last date was 20th, 22nd or 24th October 2020 for 1920 to claim ITC, right? This was the last date. As per the provisions of the law, whatever notification or amendment has come, I have already taken, considered that. Okay, so now we go on to 2020. So 2021, now there is a problem. Because the pandemic is going on, the last date, if we see is almost now October 2021. Because the last date for GSTR 9 would be December 2021. So whichever is earlier is actually October. So I don't think so we would be able to, you know, claim all the ITC by October. So I think we should start raising the voice from now itself that I would request rather all the association committee members to please start raising voice for this, because one is obviously the extension of due date for all the returns, another is the last date to obtain ITC, right? So October 2021. But yes, if automatically the date for 3B extends, this date will also be extended. So better. We shall request for extension of the GSTR 3B date for the month of September, maybe in the coming months, because if that date is extended, automatically the last date to avail ITC will also be extended, right? So this was for all the four financial year 1718, 1820, 1920 and 2021. Harish Chandra Bhatia ji saying Rule 36 subgroup 1 has already been challenged. Absolutely, sir, absolutely. Delhi High Court, Sudeep Ghosh ji. It was challenged by Avinash Mudarji as well from Gujarat. He is a very good friend. And many of the advocates have challenged this Rule 36 subgroup. It is actually legally not valid. Yes. So these were the due dates for all the four financial year. Now moving forward, already it's been now 1 hour plus. We'll just wrap up in 10 minutes maximum, and then we'll take up all the queries which will come on the screen. Okay. Reversal of ITC. Now reversal, I have listed on all the scenarios in which you need to reverse the ITC, right? So if you want to see any of the scenarios, it is already listed in my presentation. You can see I will be taking up the most important scenario, which is you need to reverse the ITC on it. Now this clause, this proviso of section 16 subsection 2 is very important. There is a lot of confusion going on. Sir, should we reverse the ITC within 180 days or not? What is this clause? What is this proviso? Please explain. Now, second proviso of section 16 subsection 2 states that, provided further that where a recipient fails to pay. Why I have highlighted, I will give you a practical example also. Where a recipient fails to pay, other than the supplies, the amount towards the value of supply along with tax payable thereon, within a period of 180 days, aapne kisi supplier ko 180 din mein agar pay nahi kiya, then an amount equal to ITC availed by the recipient shall be added to his output tax liability along with interest thereon in such manner as may be prescribed. Right? Now I will give you a practical example. Now, for example, what happened is, in this pandemic situation, my supplier said that, sir, please pay me in 1 week or 2 weeks. I'm giving you a credit period of 1 week. Right? 1 week. I said, okay, I'll pay you in 1 week. But unfortunately, due to the pandemic, I was not able to pay to my supplier. Right? So after one month happened. So what happened? I went to my supplier saying that, boss, I'm not in a condition to pay the amount of your bill. So please, let's do an agreement together, mutual agreement, saying that I will pay you after 1 year. I'll pay you after 1 year when my condition will be good. I'll pay you after 1 year, right? So we did a mutual agreement that I'll pay the invoice amount after 1 year. Now the question arises is whether this proviso, second proviso, will arise or not, because the wordings are fails to pay, right? When there is a mutual agreement between both the parties, they both have agreed that, okay, the credit period will be 1 year, then why is the law telling me that, okay, if you do not pay in 180 days, you need to reverse the ITC? I'm giving you a food for thought, right? I'm not asking you at this point of time, but yes, this is a very important issue. Arvindji is absolutely correct. Arvindji is saying, due to lockdown 2021, issue of payment within 180 days will arise. Absolutely, sir. What can be the solution? That's why I have already requested all the government authorities. I have raised my voice along with the associations that please, please give us a clarification. How do we need to proceed for this second proviso of Section 16, Subsection 2? I would request all the committee members of all the associations on this platform, since there are so many associations in this collaborative platform, that, sir, please ask for some clarification from the government authorities, because again the same thing will happen. All the sellers, all the buyers will not be able to pay within 90 days, right? Then what do we need to do? Do we need to reverse the ITC? The proviso says yes, and there is no clarification to take, right? The reason why I wanted to discuss this, because this is a very important issue. Now, third proviso says, provided also that, for example, the total amount due was 2 lakh rupees, I paid 1 lakh rupees within 180 days. So it is saying that, okay, for that 1 lakh rupees, whatever ITC was coming up, you can claim. Proportionately up by certain, right? So this is not a clarification, this is another third proviso. So proportionately, if you have paid some amount, you can take the ITC of that proportionated amount. Moving forward, value of supply definition also I have given. Many of the professionals are confused, sir. मैंने ना एक काम किया, मेरा 2 लाख का बिल था, मैंने फ्रेट नहीं दिया, मैंने उसको कमीशन नहीं दी, मैंने मेन अमाउंट दे दिया. सर, इट इज सेइंग फेल्स टू पे द वैल्यू ऑफ सप्लाई. प्लीज, सो प्लीज रेफर द डेफिनेशन ऑफ वैल्यू ऑफ सप्लाई. इट कवर्स व्हाटएवर यू वांट टू डू, राइट? एनी टैक्सेस, ड्यूटी, सेल्स, इंसिडेंटल एक्सपेंसेस, कमीशन, पैकिंग, वैल्यू ऑफ सप्लाई में सब कुछ आता है, सर. सो कभी भी प्लीज डोंट थिंक, if the bill amount was 2 lakh rupees, the commission amount was 10,000 rupees, I have not paid the commission amount, I can claim the full ITC. You cannot. The value of supply includes commission as well. Section 15 of CGST Act. Reason why I am giving you the definition, you can read it afterwards. So the definition continues. Explanation is also there for the definition. Refund. The last topic for today is refund. I will just summarize in 2 or 3 slides. Because many of the professionals think that, okay, if I have some accumulated ITC in my credit ledger, I can claim refund, right? What are the situations in which I can claim ITC refund? So any person claiming refund of any tax and interest, if any paid on such tax or any other amount, may make an application before the expiry of 2 years. So what is the time limit of making an application for refund? Before the expiry of 2 years from the relevant date. Ab, sir, relevant date kya hoti hai? ये भी तो बता दो, right? So relevant date also I have listed down. I'll explain you. Relevant date 2 years. बस आपको 2 साल याद है कि 2 साल तक आप एक application कर सकते हैं. In which cases you can claim refund? Now let's understand. Subsection 10 है sir. Subsection 10. It says provided that no refund of unutilized ITC shall be allowed in cases other than, right? So they have covered the scenario only in which I can apply for refund. Rest of the cases I cannot. So what are the cases in which I can apply? First is zero rated supplies made without payment of tax. Zero rated supplies made without payment of tax. Sanjay Kulkarni ji, can your template of this webinar will be available on Optotex site? Sanjay Kulkarni ji, absolutely. Vijay ji is my very good friend. This video will be available on TechFriends YouTube channel also and Dr. Tech's YouTube channel also. You can view this recording afterwards as well. But I would request everybody to stay because live session ka jo maza hai, sir. The way you all interact is super. So please, please be with us. Just 5 minutes left, right? Where the credit has accumulated on account of rate of tax on inputs being higher. Ye kya hai, sir? Inverted duty structure. Suna hai? I hope you would have heard of it. Inverted duty structure. So you can claim refund of ITC only in two cases. Section 54. Only in two cases. One is zero rated supplies made without payment of tax, or the credit has accumulated on account of rate of tax on inputs being higher. मतलब हुआ क्या? मेरे raw material पे 18% का GST था. मेरे output पे सिर्फ 5% का GST था. Right? So because it is being accumulated, तो accumulate होता जाएगा. So they are saying you can claim refund in this case. Inverted duty structure के अंदर ये आ जाता. These are the only two cases. Which now relevant date. It's a long definition for relevant date because in every case the relevant date will be different. I have given you all the relevant date because 2 years from the relevant date it was. So you can read out whatever clauses suffice for you because every case will be different, right? So relevant date also provisions I have given. So with this, all of the provisions with respect to the issues rather which we are facing in the ITC, I have tried my level best to raise all the issues. Now, since we have already, it's already 1.5 hours past, we will request everybody to please ask questions if any. But before asking questions, I have a small request. Please ask questions only related to ITC because there, I understand there is a lot of difficulty coming up in GST provisions. We'll also take up one by one, topic by topic. Afterwards, in many other sessions, this is just the beginning. This is just the starting, sir. Right? So please ask questions related to ITC only. Right? So I'll just start the reading the questions out. So the first question I can read on my screen is Sanjay Kulkarni ji. Okay, I have taken this question. Yes, it has been challenged to Gujarat High Court. Okay, sir. Yes. Whatever questions you have, Arvind ji, due to lockdown. Yes, I have taken that. Okay. Mehta ji saying, Rajat ji, very good presentation. Thank you so much, Mehta ji. Thank you so much. I really appreciate your sister. Rather, it's, you know, it's my pleasure to be on the TechFriends platform along with the Tech Practitioner Family Association because if they will not invite me, I wouldn't have come here, I wouldn't have deliberated, I wouldn't have met all of you. Yes, sir, presentation I am sharing right now. So just give me a moment. Yes, I have shared on the screen on all the participants who are on the Webinar Jam platform right now. I have shared the PPT copy on their screen. If still you are not able to download, no problem at all. We also mail the PPT to all the participants who are joined.
Rajat ji, you send me the presentation, we will upload it on our Google Drive. Absolutely, where sir. Everybody can download.
Absolutely, it. Absolutely. So, Padi ji, sir, is it available in PDF? Yes, Padi ji, I have shared. Okay. Kapil Makija ji, sir, please write on ITC refund in case of. Okay, sir, Makija ji, I have already mentioned all the Section 54 refund in detail. Sir, refund is a very elaborated topic and we will surely have a separate session on that. But for the ITC refund related questions, I have already listed down in the presentation. Please go through it. I assure you that you will be able to understand. Okay, Nishan Shadi, please provide PPT. Sir, Vijay ji, will share with the Google Drive, in the WhatsApp group, email also, we will share, you can download. Okay. Venkatesan ji from Vellore is saying, thanks a lot, sir, for your presentation. Kindly send me email. For sure, sir, I'll send you the email. Okay. Yes. Absolutely, sir. Okay, can...
Rajaji, there is a query on yes. YouTube, if you can just check it.
Sameer Jain ji, excellent presentation. Nishan ji, please note the PPT. Kapil Makija ji, sir, please guide on ITC refund. Sir, I have already explained, you can refer the PPT. Section 54 is actually very elaborate on all the topics. However, since the today's topic was issues in ITC, so I have deliberated on all the issues. The refund part I have taken, yes, I have taken, but in a summarized manner. If you want in detail, we will surely have a separate session on the refund itself. Section 54 in detail. All the 10 clauses for the subsections. Rohit ji is having a question. Okay. Prateek ji saying whether we have to report purchases from unregistered purchasing 3B or any other form and required to pay. Whether we have to report purchases from unregistered purchasing 3B. Prateek ji, I am not able to understand your question. If you can elaborate your question. Okay, another question is coming up. Sir, whether Rule 36 support 4 is applicable or ISD? No, sir, absolutely not. I have already answered that question. It was there in my presentation. Prateek ji, tax payment covers advanced tax also. Yeah, Rule 86. Absolutely, Prateek ji. Because, see, advanced tax is a part of your total income tax, right? So, if you have paid the total income tax more than the specified amount, yes, it will cover. It will be covered in the exception for Rule 86. Prateek ji, what if a person discovers that he forgot to pay tax of 1% and subsequently discovers the same, then he can pay through DRC 03, Rule 86B. Absolutely, Prateek ji. See, what will happen is, in this case, a notice will be issued for sure. So, please be ready to reply for that notice, right? So, yeah, you can pay it afterwards from DRC 03 and yes, you can pay. Prasada Rao, Pandiyala ji, we love you for your this being a service to taxpayer. Sir, it is all because of love and support. Imagine if you are not there, what will I do only for speaking, right? So until unless you are not there, I am nothing for you. Sir Rishi Jain ji is saying, Harish Chandra Patel, the issue of refund of taxpayer services is coming up before the Supreme Court, but now because of COVID. Absolutely, Harish ji, you correctly mentioned the Supreme Court judgment is still pending. Because of COVID, it may be postponed. Yes, it is about to come. So I think, see, the best part about the presentation is always, what I do is I try my level best to make it question answer based, right? Because whatever questions you have, they will be coming in a screen for sure. I can bet you if you have listed 10 questions, out of those at least 6 or 7 would have come in the presentation itself. MK Padiji, it would be better to organize a webinar on case law decisions by different courts on ITC. Absolutely, sir, we'll try to do that. Srinivasan ji, RCM GPA, the transporter submits the bill after 3 months. What is the implication? Srinivasan ji, yes, there is a problem in that if he is submitting the bill. Sir, the problem is, I am telling you, similarly in the banks, right, there is KYC, know your customer, right? So, what we need to do is gradually, I understand that is very tough, but gradually what the government is expecting is, with whomsoever you are dealing with, you have to know your supplier. So similar to KYC, know your customer, the concept has to be know your supplier as well. KYS. So gradually start communicating to your clients that KYS ki karna padega. Please try to deal only with those suppliers whom you know that actually they are very compliant, they will be issuing invoices on time and they will be filing returns on time. Right? Unregistered purchases are reporting job work. Prateek ji, only related to ITC. Sir, I understand there are many issues coming up. Naresh Chelarmani ji, can we apply on sale under LUP? Also, few merchants are merchant export supplier. LUT se hota hai sir, later on the techniques aap kar sakte. Absolutely, sir. Rishi Jain ji, can a company take ITC on purchase of second-hand goods from a seller who has opted margin scheme? Rishi ji, it depends on the kind of goods, sir. Sir, actually you have to refer section 17, subsection 5, subsection 8. For example, if there is a good, if you have seen passenger transportation vehicle, if you take the example of passenger transportation vehicle, right? If I buy, many of the people ask me, sir, I have bought a second-hand car, sir. Can I use ITC? Sir, there are a lot of conditions which you need to check, whether it is used for the business purpose, right? Now, for example, a car, how it will be used for the business purpose? If your employee or if your director comes and goes by the car for the office, that is not a business purpose, right? Notice will be issued for sure. It might be disallowed afterwards. Sir, pakde gaye to chor hai, nahi pakde gaye to raja. It's like this, right? But make sure you follow the law. You read the provisions of the law. Always I suggest, the biggest issue right now is, I'm telling you, there are actually 3-4 kind of, law at this point of time. One is the GST law, one is the portal law, another is the WhatsApp law, and what we have started doing is we have focused more on the WhatsApp now these days. Yes, WhatsApp is very important for communication, but not for understanding the provisions of the law. Yes, we need to attend these webinars, we need to read the law as well. Lakshman ji, nice presentation. Please have another topic soon for sure, sir. Vijay ji is my very good friend, we'll surely have. Okay, so it's already, I think, 6:30 past. Vijay ji, if you permit, we can just have a decision.
Thank you, Rajat ji, for a beautiful session and very nicely answering all the questions that have come from the participants, and with your simple and easy language, you have explained the provisions relating to issues in ITC in a very simple way that even a person like me who doesn't practice in GST was interested in listening to it so that I can try and understand what it is. Because I am not a technical person, I don't practice in GST. So, but I was still trying to understand, and Bharat would agree with me that being a practitioner himself, the way you have explained. And I would now, before giving a vote of thanks, I would like our President Atam Tektenani ji to say a few words before I proceed to the vote. Atam ji, you are there. I think there is a connection problem. Okay, so friends, I would now go ahead with the vote of thanks. Rajat ji, thank you for remembering your promise last year that yes, we would do a joint seminar with Tax Friends and Tax Practitioner Association and other associations of our consortium. Friend, Rajat ji, I would like to inform you, we had formed this consortium during the pandemic only, and with this consortium, we have done around 100 seminars and 2 national tax conferences online. And the first very one was also done by us in July last year. So at that time I had approached you also for a topic. You said yes, and then unfortunately you were not keeping well. I would like to thank you personally for having accepted our request and remembering our request and then giving us a very good topic. Friends, I am sure you would also agree the way he has explained. I don't think we would need any other explanation on all these topics. Yes, we look forward to other topics from you also, and maybe a long tie-up jointly with OptoTax, with our other association, so we can do many other programs in the future jointly. Thank you. I would request everybody to carry a vote of thanks, which they would be from their houses, because now we cannot see them. So thank you very much. Bharat, you would like to add something?
Yeah, Rajat, thank you. It was a very nice session which we had. And I'm seeing the chat boxes. You're getting...
Vijay, can you hear me?
Hello?
Vijay, can you hear me?
Yes, now we can.
Hello?
Yeah, Atam. Atam, boliye.
Rajat sir, I'm Atam Tekchandani.
Yes, Atam ji. Jai Shri Lal sir.
Sir, namaskar. Sorry, I'm very, very bad in... these gadgets.
No problem.
Sir, thank you very much. It was really nice hearing you this evening. And we'll meet in future again. And thank you to Vijay also for organizing this. Abhi thoda mahol sudhar jaye to fir milenge sir, personally.
Bilkul sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you, Vijay.
Yeah. And Bharat, before you move, just one attendance confirmation. We had around 200 here and up to 180 on YouTube, the maximum that we had gone. And definitely this will be looked by other people also in the future, because it is there on YouTube and people will be watching. Our channel is one of the most watched our channel. You can see from there. Yes, Bharat, please.
Yeah, Rajat, what I was trying to say is, by seeing your presentation was fantastic. Practicing in GST for so many years now and practicing in indirect taxes, I could relate to what your things were and the pain from which you were speaking on certain points. At the same time, I was seeing the chat box. I was very interested that people aapko sachi GST ka master mante hai, kyunki input chhod ke bahut sare questions aise the aapke upar bumper aa rahe the. So yes, Vijay, we have to see to it that Rajat is coming again to our meet next month. May mein inko block karna hai apne ko, may mein inka ek lecture rakhenge. It was a real pleasure having you here. Thanks.
Sure. Thank you so much, Bharat ji. And I would like to just 2 minutes speak to all my participants. First of all, thank you so much for joining. Thank you so much for taking out your precious time I understand it is a very tough time going on. Even at this tough time, where everybody is getting some or the other negative news, you all joined. Thank you so much for that. And I really appreciate the way you come in all our webinars, whether it is organized with any of the association. Now TechFriends is there, Bharat is there with us. We start conducting many webinars there also with them. And yes, stay safe, stay at home. The only point is, we have to take care of our parents similar to they have taken our care in the childhood, right? It's like when they used to hold our hand and take us in the to the hospitals and to the doctors. Similar to that, we have to take care of our parents. So please make sure that we take care of our parents very nicely, take care of our children very nicely, and please stay safe, please stay take care. With this, thank you so much, everyone. Thank you to TechFriends Association. Thank you, Vijayji. Thank you, Arpani. Thank you, Bharatji. And namaskar, Sat Sri Akal, Jai Hind. And Sabin, Munja Sabin Sindhi
TechFriends. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Munja Sabin Sindhi TechFriends members ke bhi.
Thank you. I think we can cut the YouTube link now. Yeah. Let us.